Dear student, myself Ramanand Shukla from LPM Public School, Gola Bazar, Gorakhpur. Dear student, in this video we are going to read SST of Class 5, Chapter 5. Our today's topic is the hot desert region. And now we are going to start the chapter. As we travel away from the equatorial region towards the tropics, dear student, there are two tropics, Tropic of Cancer and Tropics of Capricorn. We reach at hot desert region. A desert is a place that receives very little rainfall. In fact, some deserts do not receive any rainfall for years together. Dear student, what is desert? Is clear. Desert is a place that receives very little or no rainfall. We can understand it with the help of this map, World Hot Deserts. Now, location. If you look at the map, you will see that the hot deserts of the world are located near the tropics, between latitudes 15 degree and 13 degree north and south. Then the location is clear. The location of the hot deserts is between the latitudes 50 degree and 30 degree north and south in both hemispheres, northern and southern. The main among them are the Sahara, the Great Australian Desert, the Arabian Desert, the Thar, the Kalahari, the Namib and the Atacama Desert. These are the important deserts. Now we are going to know the climate. This region receives very little rainfall, less than 25 centimeter in a year. In fact, most desert receives less than 5 centimeter of annual rainfall. Compare this to the equatorial region that receive between 150 and 250 centimeter of rainfall in a year. If we compare it, then it is very little. As there is very little moisture here, no clouds form. Without clouds to block the heat, the land heats up quickly during the day and cools down fast during the night. Thus, the temperature varies greatly during the course of a day, moving from extremely hot to cold within hours. Because in desertous region, due to less moisture, there is no clouds, and clouds act as an umbrella from the heats of the sun. So here, due to less clouds, the land of desertous regions quickly heated and quickly cold. So the temperature of day is extremely high and temperature of night is extremely cold. This is the climate or the main region for the desert. So desert are not favorable for our habitats or human settlements. Now we are going to know about plant life. Plants find it difficult to grow in deserts due to the lack of water, because desertous region receive very less rainfall. The plants that do manage to grow here are hardy plants that have adapted to desert condition. Only plants develop here, they adapted the desert condition. Some plants have thick stems that store waters. The plants found in this region, they have thick stems that store water. The leaves of desert plant usually have a waxy coating, or they are reduced to spines of thorn. This helps reduce water lost from the leaves. Some plants that grow here, like the cactus, have a wide network of roots close to the surface. This allows them to absorb rainwater quickly. Other plants like acacia have long roots that can reach water sources deep below the ground. Dear student, the plants of the desertous region, they have waxy coating on their leaves. This helps reduce the water loss from the leaves. And the trees found here, their roots are close to the surface for absorb rainwater quickly. You can see in the figure the roots of cactus above the roots of acacia tree. Now, trees like the date palm grow around oases, and oases is a place in the desert where fresh water from a spring or well comes up to the surface, supporting the growth of plants. Trees like date and palm ground around the oases. Oases is a water source in the desert where fresh water from a spring or well comes up the surface naturally. You can see in the figure a cactus, how the stems is fleshy and the leaves are reduced to spin. An oasis in the Sahara Desert. Now we are going to know about the animal life. Snakes, lizards, fox, and a variety of insects and birds are found in the hot desert regions of the world. To escape the heat, many of them rest in shady places, like under stones or in burrows during the day, and come out to hunt at night. Birds like the eagle and the kite soar high above the ground to escape the heat. Dear student, here we found snakes and other species. They rest under stone or in burrows during the day and came out to hunt at night, because at night climate is pleasant and favorable. Birds like the eagle and kite soar high above the ground to escape the heat. In these birds like eagle, they are maintain a height from the ground to escape the heat because ground is very ground of the desertous region have very high temperature. For thousands of years, camels have been the main means of transport for people living in desert. As you know, camel is also known as sheep of the desert. They are therefore also known as sheep of the desert. The camel is especially well adapted to life in the desert. It stores fat in its humps and water in its body. This helps it travel for days without water or food. Its feet are large and flat, which helps it walk in the sand. Next point is, it has small nostrils and two rows of eyelashes to help keep the sand out to its nose and eye. These are the special qualities they are founded in the camels. That's why he especially well adapted to life in the desert and also known as sheep of the desert. Dear student, we read and understand about the lives of hot desertous regions, and in next video we read about the human life of this region and the challenges facing this region. Thank you for watching.